humans from the beginning of time. We either ran away from animals or we ran at them to hunt them. It's one of the oldest things that connects us to who we are in this world. And we're in a time where, you know, less and less people are doing it and less people are connecting to these things that are an established part of what humans are.
The animal and you are both part of nature, and you're both part of something that is actually larger than yourself. That goes back to the start of time. Now we live in offices, we live in cities, and that's just very recent. But our DNA still has that connection to nature. The cool key experiences here is that you get to experience the entirety of life in that moment.
Say, for instance, if this was back to the original Africa, you know, you'd have the lions, you would have different things like that. It'd be more of a predator situation that controls the animals of what food they have to eat and things of that fashion. It's kind of a relationship. Well, when you take the lions out of it, or some of the other predators out of it, the hunting you have to actually do so that the animals don't starve each other. And just like this area just came through about a 4-year drought, I understand. If all this stayed barren, the animals basically would all die. And so you've got to hunt them to a point, but at the same time, you don't hunt too many. You let them repopulate. And I feel that the management of these ranches is as much to promote new growth of wildlife as it is to hunt.
Yeah, he's out again on the right of that bush. Hey.
What are you looking at?
Well, we're trying to find those buffalo. There's one big one down there, but he's all by himself. Well, I'm Brent Pratka. Today we're trying to find a big Cape buffalo, and the plan is to get as close as we can so I can shoot him with my new 5095 lever action rifle, and then we're gonna take it back to camp, and me and my brothers are gonna cut some of the meat out, and we're gonna do the cooking for the camp this evening with the harvest.
This is our fourth trip here, and one of the things we always like to do, we like to take some of the game that we kill and prepare it in the Texas way. So we're gonna make us a sop here, and my sons are working on the meat.
You know, I shot my buffalo at 13 yards. I mean, you're face to face with an animal that's capable of turning over a truck, and it's a challenge, and it's a thrill. But at the end of the day, we take the meat back to camp, and right now, as soon as we get done with this interview, we're gonna run back over to the campfire, because we've got that buffalo in the barbecue pit, and we're gonna feed the entire camp.
And that's what we feed our clients. Everybody wants to know what they're eating at nighttime when you give them a nice steak or a filet. That's the kudu you shot yesterday, or that's the gemsbok you shot the day before. We're able to regulate a species on our property. If we need X amount of kudu, we know we can harvest X amount of kudu.
If it wouldn't be for hunting, we would have starved, literally. I mean, my family was a very, very poor family. My daddy would go out fishing. He would catch fish, and that would be, you know, meals for several days. And all this game is what fed us when I was growing up. It's such a good feeling to be able to know that you can go out and harvest animals and feed your family with it.
I think that's something very important, that if you eat meat, then you should be able to go get it yourself too. Okay, if you're somebody that doesn't eat meat and you don't like to kill anything, perfectly fine. I totally understand that. But if you eat meat, then you take a look at how chickens and cows are harvested and how they're, the atrocities that they get put through. Here, they live free. And how would they live in the wild? They would live free until some predator would get them or they would die of natural means.
One of the big things in South Africa with having so many species and opportunities available to the hunter is that we all have to remember we're here for a reason. We're here for conservation. If it wasn't for hunters' dollars coming into South Africa, we would have a lot less variety of species available to us that have been here forever. The economical growth that hunters bring in their dollars to South Africa, the trackers, the skinners, the housemaids, managers, it just goes all the way down the line.
Some people, you know, you go golfing, some people they like cars, I just live and breathe hunting. I work just enough so I could go hunting, you know, hunting and fishing. Something about the outdoors is just where I want to be. I'm, for lack of a better word, like very, very conscious about good food and where it comes from, and I want healthy stuff. So wild game is some of the best meat on the planet. There's no hormones, there's nothing done. It lived a better life than any hamburger you ever bought in a store.
Every single one of these guys loves nature, loves the conservation of it, and they love animals, and they understand the hierarchy. So, and why it's so important that there's a certain number at a certain time in a certain season, and that balance has to be kept. So that their philosophy is from a conservation perspective as opposed to a killing perspective.
They're taking the meat, we eat all we can, and you know, they're giving to the villages, all the staff that works here, it's a you know, given to the orphanages and utilizing it for, you know, really nothing goes to waste, and that was really neat to see.
So we have a program where the last day of the hunt, we're able to butcher up a lot of this meat and we package it up and we call either a local school, an orphanage. And if you've never been a volunteer for anything like this, it is the most humbling experience and heartwarming experience that you can ever do. I cry every time I go. No doubt about it, I cry. I'm gonna start crying now. It's incredible. It's very heartwarming. And we like to do that. Sorry, guys.